Location and weather data are fundamental when designing a PV system and an essential input for PVSyst simulations. In this tutorial, we will explain how location and weather data are stored in PVSyst using SIT and MET files. We will then show you how to manage the Medio database. There are two different kinds of files that manage weather data in PVSyst. The first are the site definition files. They contain the GPS data of the site and the site description, including name, country, and time zone. Additionally, the site files of PVSyst always hold monthly weather data. At a minimum, this includes global horizontal irradiation and ambient temperature. Optionally, the data may include diffuse irradiance, wind velocity, and other parameters. PVSyst comes installed with a database of 2,500 sites from around the world, which hold monthly measured data from Medionorm. The site files have a .sit extension and are stored in the workspace directory /site. The other file type concerns hourly weather data. In PVSyst, for historical reasons, we name them Meteo files. The Meteo files contain, at a minimum, global horizontal irradiance and ambient temperature data. These are basic variables necessary for performing a simulation. They may also include diffuse irradiance, wind velocity, and other variables. Each Meteo file also includes a full site for the definition of its location. Meteo files usually contain 8,760 hourly data values to encompass a full year. However, it is possible to create partial Meteo files with some reduced periods down to only one day. This may be useful for analyzing measured data on site. The Meteo files have an extension .met and are stored in the workspace directory /Meteo. PVSyst requires an MET file with hourly data and a corresponding SIT file to perform simulations. The MET file can be imported from various sources, or PVSyst can create an MET file through synthetic generation from monthly data. Furthermore, importing custom measured data is also possible. To manage the weather files and the sites in PVSyst, click on Databases. These eight buttons concern SIT and MET files. In this tutorial, we will briefly look at each of these buttons, but in-depth usage of these buttons will be explored in the next tutorials. The Geographical Sites button brings up all the SIT files. The search bar allows you to search by plain text and to filter by continent or country. You can also mark sites as favorites using this button, and then filter by favorites using the search dropdown. You can open any site by double-clicking on it or by using the Open button. Here, you can view various data about the site location as well as the monthly weather data. You can also create a new site anywhere on Earth, either by supplying its coordinates or by choosing it on a map. The Synthetic Generation tool creates a synthetic MET file of hourly values from the 12 monthly values of an SIT file. These two buttons allow you to view data from MET files. The first button allows you to view the data of an individual MET file in detail. Panel on the left shows characteristics of the source file. On the right, you can display graphs and tables of the MET file. The Compare Meteo Data tool allows you to compare the annual irradiation of different weather files. Both SIT and MET files can be compared. To add an SIT file for comparison, choose it from the first row and click add to comparison. To add an MET file, select it from the drop-down and click Add to Comparison. To remove a file, right-click it. The graph on the left compares yearly global horizontal irradiation between the files that are added. This tool allows you to define the RMS of the Gaussian distribution of a set of Medio data files for different years. This is used in the P50-P90 tool. You can export this table or copy the graph to the clipboard using these buttons. The last buttons concern importing Medio files. Importing from a known format will allow you to use databases such as SolarGIS and PVGIS to import hourly data. You can query these databases using location names. You can also query these databases by using the latitude and longitude coordinates. You can also import from a custom file. This dialog will allow you to search for an hourly or sub-hourly weather data file on your computer, import it, and convert it to an MET file for use in PVSYST. This button will allow you to generate a specific type of MET file whose hourly dataset is a typical meteorological year, or TMY. To calculate a TMY, weather data from a series of multiple years are used to approximate an average year from that set of data. There are various algorithms to make this calculation. You can learn more about these algorithms in the help. In order to use this tool, you need to have at least 3 consecutive years of MET files from the same site. To generate TMY files using the ISO or NSRDB algorithms, you need at least 10 consecutive years of MET files. By default, PVSYST does not come installed with such data. However, you can import this data using the Known Format button. In this video, we have discussed the 2 different files used for site and weather data. SIT files contain the location and geographical properties of a site, as well as monthly weather data. MET files contain hourly weather data. We have also walked through the database tools used to manage and create SIT and MET files in PVSYST.